Hey. Hey. So many adventures to choose from. Did you see the history clubs going to Gettysburg? Could they be more cliche?
I'm kind of in the middle of Eco Club stuff.
Okay. Well, I just joined Eco Club. Now can we talk? It's club business.
Seriously, I'm busy. I'm like organizing our whole trip.
Okay, fine. Look, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about what happened the other night. That was totally weird.
Weird?
Yeah. I don't know, I just feel bad.
It's fine, it's a party. People hook up. That's what happens. Or was there something else?
No. Used to you and Mom fighting. That's like supposed to be my job.
We're not fighting, Bren. I'm just annoyed. I feel like I made my decision and she just doesn't accept it. But on the bright side, something awesome happened at work today.
What?
I got my first solo byline.
Oh my God, really? You're like a real reporter now.
I know. It's crazy. I can't believe it's finally happening. Oh, with everything that's been going on, I'm fighting with Mom.
Are you gonna celebrate?
I have plans with Dominic tonight. Seriously?
What? What happened?
They're pulling my article. I gotta go.
Hey, Dominic. I'm gonna be late. I have to go back to the office. There's something going on with my story. I'll keep you posted.
Dominic.
April. Surprise.
You knew about this too? Oh, you saw me almost have a heart attack when I got that text.
I know. I wish I could have recorded that. You should have seen your face. You were so mad.
Okay.
Oh, great.
Never have I ever been attracted to someone of the same sex.
Oh, Brenna.
I knew it. What do you mean you knew it? Do you want to tell her or should I?
Hey, shut up.
This girl from my school, I met her. She's adorable.
What about Kieran?
It's possible to like two people at the same time. What's the big deal? Okay, now it's my turn. Never have I ever been attracted to anyone in this room.
Hey, can I talk to you?
What's wrong? Is Graham still hitting on you? Just tell him you eat red meat and he'll leave you alone.
Come here.
Who is this?
Just tell me, who is she?
I didn't want to tell you like this, but that girl is our half-sister. Her name is Natalie Ortiz.
What? Does this mean that Dad...
Yeah, I guess he had an affair a long time ago.
So was his whole marriage to Mom a lie?
I don't think so. I don't know. I'm so sorry you found out like this. I was gonna tell you, but with everything that's been happening, it was just never the right time.
Oh my God. Dad.
Look, I don't want this to make you hate him. That was my first reaction too, but We have no idea how he felt about that woman or mom. And you said it yourself, maybe it's possible to like two people. And who knows, maybe he was planning on telling us the truth at some point and then he, you know, was gone before he got the chance. If there's one thing I've learned since getting sick, it's that being honest is much harder than it seems. Especially if you're afraid you'll hurt someone you really care about.
What are you doing here? You haven't been answering my texts, and I wanted to talk about what happened.
We did. You apologized. It's fine.
I know, but I didn't say everything that I wanted to say. When you caught me with Kieran in your room, I felt really bad. Like, worse than I've ever felt about a guy, and I don't know what that means. All I know is I can't deal with you hating me.
Brenna, I don't hate you. Look, it's just hard when you're into girls and you have no idea if they're into girls. But you hurt my feelings because I don't know. I felt like we had a thing.
I did too.
Did. Past tense.
No. Present tense.
You going somewhere?
Yeah, Miami with the Eco Club. We leave super early tomorrow.
Since when are you in the Eco Club?
Since whatever.
Is that girl in it or something? The one you love?
I don't love her. But yeah, she's in it.
Can't believe your school's taking you to Miami. The only field trip we took in high school was to Fenway.
Hey, Abe. Did you know when you search Natalie Ortiz on the internet, there are like 1,000 results that come up?
I did know that, actually.
What else do you know about her?
Not much. Just that she lives near where Dad had his writing retreat.
In Florida? Guess writing wasn't the only thing he was doing there.
Morning, girls. Hey, Brenna, are you packed for your trip?
I'll finish when I get home from school.
Don't forget you have to be at the hospital by 3 to get your cheek swabbed.
Hey, thanks for doing that.
Yeah, of course. I'll swab my cheek for you anytime, girl.
All right, you really need to pack.
In a minute.
I'm not putting out till that bag is packed.
Isn't it weird that I'm going to Florida, like, right after I find out that I have a sister there?
Where does she live?
Key Largo? It's like an hour away from where we're gonna be. I found her address after April told me where she lives. I could totally take a cab there.
Brenna.
Maybe I need to go find her. Maybe this is why the universe wanted me to join the Eco Club.
No, the universe wanted you to join the Eco Club because its president is really hot.
Seriously. Maybe this is why I'm just finding out about her now. If April needs a bone marrow transplant and I'm not a match, maybe this girl could be one. They say siblings are the best chance.
All right, well, if you're gonna go find her, I'll go with you.
I can go alone. You, like, love ecology.
It sounds so nerdy when you call it ecology.
Yeah, well, you're a nerd.
Not so much of a nerd that I won't break the rules every once in a while.
I'm glad you're getting away. Take your mind off the stress around here for a little while.
Yeah, you too. Have a fun sailing trip.
It's not really a trip, just a couple hours on the boat with the caregivers group.
Doesn't exactly sound like a break from the stress. Sitting around crying with other parents about your sick kids.
Believe me, that's the last thing this group does. I'm getting the sense their meetups are mostly about drinking.
Now you're talking.
I'm kidding. There's your van. Have a great time in Florida.
Be safe.
what do you think it was about that place that Dad loved so much?
I don't know. Maybe you'll get an idea when you're down there.
Everyone, meet in front of the Hanson Ballroom at 6 p.m. sharp for the conference. You'll sign in with Annie, our club secretary.
How's the keynote address coming, Mr. Ostrowski?
When
I was running for class president, it really helped to rehearse my speech in front of the mirror.
Well, clearly it worked for you, Miss President. Good, good advice.
Okay, Annie said she'll sign us in later. Let's get a cab. You really think Mr. Ostrowski's not going to notice? He can barely speak in front of 20 students in environmental science. He's gonna be a mess tonight. You ready? You can do this, Brenna. Well, I guess she's not home, so... Hi, I'm Brenna. Carver? So, you probably already know this, but turns out we have the same dad.
I know. And I'm sorry that you came all the way down here for me to tell you that I want nothing to do with you. Or your family. You probably should have called first.
Okay, how long is the wait for a cab?
We can't give up so easily.
What are we supposed to do? I can't force her to talk to me. Hi, yes, I'm here. 2 hours?
Yeah, we're forcing her to talk to you.
Will you just talk to us for a minute?
I thought I told you.
Natalie, please.
Who do you think you are just showing up at my house out of nowhere like this? I'm sorry if it sucked finding out your dad had a secret kid. Did you think for a second what it must have been like for me being the secret kid?
I'm sorry, I hadn't thought.
Well, maybe you should have before you flew all the way down here.
Look, coming here might have been a really impulsive thing to do, but I came with good intentions. I swear. Things have been really crazy with my family lately. Mostly with my older sister, April.
Oh, right. That freak who chased me through the cemetery. I recognized her. It's not like I hadn't looked you guys up years ago. Seems like you lead pretty perfect lives.
Actually, April has cancer.
Oh. I'm sorry. That must be hard.
That's kind of why I came down here. I wanted to meet my other sister. Aren't you curious too?
Fine. Let's get to know each other. You guys coming or what?
Did somebody say Mai Tais?
Thanks, Natalie. Oh, it's on my mom. Figured she wouldn't mind me using her card for our little family reunion.
My mom would. She doesn't even know that I'm here.
Really? You're hardcore.
Yeah, she'd freak out if she knew. She's pretty uptight. So are you and your mom close?
Very. I mean, we kind of had to be since it was just the two of us. Why are we talking about our moms when we have delicious drinks in front of us? Cheers, bitches. Are you two lesbians?
I am.
Let's dance. Woo, come on.
Greer, what's wrong?
I do not feel well.
Hey, can we get some water, please?
Claire can barely stand. She was fine a second ago, and now she's, like, wasted.
That sucks. Maybe you should dump the lightweight.
I don't think she's drunk. Did you put something in her drink?
You think I drugged her? Wow. Should have known you rich New England girls would have found some way to look down on us.
I don't think coming here was a good idea.
What, did you think it was going to be some heartfelt, tearful reunion? You and me? We've got nothing in common except the fact that we share a dad. Not that he was the only one in my life that much. I was a part-time kid. You and April were always going to be the only daughters who really got him.
Look, I didn't come here to find a new best friend. I already have one. My sister, April. I was going to ask if you would get tested to be a possible bone marrow donor for her, but now that I've met you, I realize you are way too selfish to ever do anything like that.
Well, you got one thing right.
How's Sarah doing, by the way?
I haven't seen her in a while. Oh, you didn't know your mom knew about me? Well, we've met. Guess your family's not as perfect as you thought. One point for the bastard.
How are you feeling?
I've been better. Thanks for taking such good care of me last night.
Yeah, of course. It's the least I could do. I feel terrible that that happened.
Greer, Brenna, how'd you two like my keynote address last night?
It was phenomenal, Mr. Ostrowski. I had no idea how harmful ocean acidification was on marine life. You were very Jacques Cousteau-like.
Whoa. Thanks, Greer. Practicing in front of a mirror definitely helped. Okay, everyone, let's get moving. These dolphins aren't gonna swim with themselves.
How did you... Annie recorded it on her phone and sent it to me. I knew I had to cover all my bases.
Thanks for going with me to meet Natalie. I would have regretted it if I hadn't. Even though...
She sucked.
Kinda, yeah.
She's here! Brenna's home!
Oh, good. Everyone's finally home. How about a little bridge before dinner?
Oh, yes.
Grandma, you know we suck.
Oh, good. I'll take all your money then. Anyway, no one could be worse than this one.
So, Brenna, tell us everything. How was your trip to Florida?
It was informational, to say the least.
All right, ladies, chit chat. I'm gonna kick some butt here.
I will keep score.
Funny? No.
I remember how to play the game on your barrel.
Four suits.
Four suits. I'm terrible. It's really not hard.